In today's video, I am going to explain anatomy around abdominal area, particularly around upper abdominal area. This area is called pit of stomach. Pit of stomach or solar plexus. There's many muscles around this area. So I'm going to explain superficial muscles first and deep muscle later. Okay, what kind of muscles are around this area, pit of stomach? You see abdominal muscles and inferior part. What is this one? This is rectus abdominis. Rectus abdominis, this is left side. Okay, and this is right side. You see other muscle on right side. This is external oblique. External oblique. You see, these muscles attach around upper abdominal area, and there are more abdominal muscles. Deep to external oblique, there is internal oblique. Internal oblique. And let's go back to left side. Deep to rectus abdominis, there is transverse abdominis. Transverse abdominis. These abdominal muscles around this area, around ribcage and around xiphoid process. Basically, they attach to this area. Now, what are functions of abdominal muscles? Basically, it is trunk flexion. Trunk flexion is basically sit-up movement, core training movement, okay? That bends trunk forward, right? So how can you apply today's anatomy for exercise, yoga, and Pilates? Well, many yoga poses, many Pilates exercises require good core extension. Core extension means you bend core backward, or you keep your posture straight up. This requires good extension position. Okay, extension, right? And what is function of abdominal muscles? That is core flexion. Remember, core flexion is like sit-up movement, roll-up movement. Where are abdominal muscles located? Right here. Just front part of abdomen. And pit of stomach is around here. There are many muscles around pit of stomach. What if these muscles get tight? These muscles tend to bring core to flexion because their function is flexion. Then it's hard to go to extension. Does it make sense? So if your abdominal muscles get tight, it's hard to go to extension. Again, extension is important to maintain posture upright or even go farther away. Thus, flexibility of pit of stomach is important. Why? Because abdominal muscles are around this area. That makes sense. Then other muscles are related to this area. Let's look at it. Okay, above pit of stomach, there is big chest muscle like this. This is pectoralis major. Pectoralis major or pec major. Let's focus on inferior part of pec major. That attaches to lower part of, you know, ribcage. You see that? Then, interesting thing is, lower part of pectoralis major attaches to myofascia. The myofascia is called rectus sheath. Rectus sheath. See, there is attachment right here. You can say pec major and rectus abdominis are connected. Yes, they are connected. So if pit of stomach gets tight, that affects for abdominal muscles and for pectoralis major. What is function of pectoralis major? Basically, that moves shoulder. That moves shoulder for multi-direction. You can bring shoulder to front way, up way, and then it can close shoulder. Tech major has so many things to do for shoulder movement. Let's go back to a real person. Again, abdominal muscles are on this area, right? And pec major is about this area. Remember, rectus abdominis and pec major are connected by connective tissue, right? Then, if you want to do this kind of upright shoulder position, then if your pec major is tight, it's hard to bring your shoulder up because tightness of pec major pulls shoulder this way, then tendency is her shoulders might go a little bit forward. That is why this region, pit of stomach, is both important for abdominal movement and shoulder movement. So if you do yoga, Pilates, and many exercise, you may focus around pit of stomach. Then if your abdomen is tight, you can focus this region, then do exercise and stretching. Having visualization in your head increases efficiency of exercise. So you can use same thing for shoulder exercise. This is superficial part around pit of stomach. Let's go to deep muscles. Okay, this is deep part or pit of stomach. I want to focus on two muscles. First muscle is this one. This muscle is important for breathing. This is diaphragm. Diaphragm, primary breathing muscle. You don't have to focus on this area. I want you to focus on this region. This kind of leg shape structure is crura. Crura of diaphragm. Crura means leg. So they are literally legs of diaphragm. They attach to lumbar spines. Okay, lumbar spines. Then they are very close around pit of stomach. So you can focus on this area, then you can focus on breathing. Okay, that's important region. Then crura of diaphragm and psoas are connected. Diaphragm and psoas have myofascial connection. So like this. If your psoas is tight, maybe diaphragm is affected. Vice versa, if your diaphragm is tight, psoas can be affected. Again, crura of diaphragm is at level of pit of stomach, or a little bit inferior, but slightly inferior. When you do breathing and you can focus around pit of stomach, then maybe bring your breathing right here. You might have different sensation of breathing. You can apply this anatomy for breathing, yoga, and practice, and exercise. It makes sense. And if you go even a little bit inferior from this region, there is psoas. That's the same thing. If you use hip exercise, hip movement, maybe you can focus this area to initiate leg movement. Why leg movement? Because function of psoas is hip flexion. This muscle moves hip joint. That is good to know. Then let's go back to this person. Pit of stomach is about here. Crura of diaphragm is around this area, right? It's slightly inferior. Then if you go even more inferior, there is psoas. You can bring intention this area for breathing and leg movement. Why leg movement? Again, psoas moves hip joint. So, in first part, I explained superficial muscles right here. Rectus abdominis, external oblique, internal oblique, and pec major right here. So, depends on where your tightness is, you can change intention of depth. If you feel superficial part is tight, focus on abdominal muscles and pec major. If you feel deeper part is tight, then switch your intention. Go deeper and focus on diaphragm and psoas muscle. You know, having visualization of anatomy is important. If you have clear visualization, your efficiency of stretch and exercise increases a lot. And there is torsion. deep to pit of stomach, there are a lot of important structures, such as artery here. This is abdominal aorta. Abdominal aorta. The blood of this abdominal aorta brings blood to internal organs and lower extremity. And this one is vein. This is inferior vena cava. Inferior vena cava. Blood of inferior vena cava goes back to heart. That sounds very important. Plus, there are a lot of autonomic nervous system around big blood vessels. An important autonomic nervous system around here is celiac plexus. Celiac plexus, or it is called solar plexus. Do you remember what is the name of this region? This is pit of stomach or solar plexus. Solar plexus means kind of a mass of nervous tissue deep to this region. Celiac plexus is mass of nervous system and that kind of radiates to many internal organs. This is very important place for autonomic nervous system and internal organ. These nervous tissues and big blood vessels are deep to pit of stomach. So if you do myofascial release or manual therapy around here, be careful. This is very fragile, very important area. And if you do exercise around here, and if you have pain, stomachache, and something discomfort, you may avoid doing intense exercise. Why? Because there are a lot of important tissues. So in today's video, I explained basic anatomy around pit of stomach. There are numerous muscles and important structures. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.